Hey, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Patrick coming to you from the Philippines, wearing my Rapture shirt. Hallelujah. Those have been watching my videos for a long time. You know, this is my Rapture shirt. Hey, brothers and sisters. I just wanted to give you a little something. Because, you know, I'm not, you know, I try to hear from the Lord in my spirit, and I'm not a big confirmation guy. Some people get lots of confirmations. Now, me, I mostly try to hear from the Lord in my heart, you know, so, and through His Word. But those of you who've been following my videos, you remember way back I did a video, and I made all these videos about the Florida Lee, and I've been following up on that. So much so that when I made a video about the Florida Lee, it was really bizarre. There was a, somehow there was a Florida Lee stain on the tile of the floor of my room there on my video. Some of you guys saw it. I need to go to try to find that video. I know that Sister Tonto can probably find it for me and send me the link. But in the new, the third orphanage that we're doing, I was just over there tonight. There was one room that had carpet in it, which nobody ever has carpet in the Philippines because it's so hot. And anyway, in this one bedroom, they had carpet, and which I've never seen in the Philippines, except for maybe in a hotel or something. But anyway, it had rained, and the gutter was stopped up and rested, and the water had gotten under the roof and drained into the carpet there through the ceiling into the carpet. So that's one reason why we got it for half price. But while we did, we tore out the carpet. So I told my wife, she got her brother-in-law, my sister-in-law's husband, and they went to the to a store and bought some tiles. I told her to go ahead and get tiles because carpet is so hot in the Philippines anyway. I mean, you know, carpet's already bad enough for you, full of mold, much less in a place where it's 100 degrees, I mean, you know, and humidity. So anyway, we put out the carpet and my wife bought tiles, and I went there tonight and looked at the tiles that they bought, and then on the tile that's going to go in this room is the floor. There's a, you know, it's a pattern of lilies, and they're Florida Lee, and that it's going to go on the floor. And I didn't think anything about it. I was like, well, you know, my wife doesn't know, and it's, you know, it's only, you know, I'm not one of those people that thinks that symbols have power. The devil thinks symbols have power, but symbols have no power over the name of Jesus, you know. And anyway, so as I was walking back here from that other place, I was walking. It's about a mile or so just to get a little exercise, go in there and back. And the Lord just spoke to me and said, remember that what I just told you on the flooring, on the tile of the other house where I made my videos, on the floor, on the tile was a Florida Lee. And this room, you know, this house that we're buying for the orphanage has 5 bedrooms. And there'll be 3 rooms for orphans, 1 room for us, and then another room for a mission house. If any of you guys visit, as I said, I'm going to have a bedroom there for visitors from the States or wherever you come from, Australia and Europe or whatever. If you're welcome to come to the Philippines, and I have a room there for you guys. Mission house. Lots of people said they wanted to come. I guess I've got at least 10 people that say they're going to come in the next year or two. So I got a room for you guys. Then we also have a room at the orphanage, at orphanage number 1, which is about 2 hours from here. Anyway, the room where I will be is the one where the tiles is going to be. So on the floor in the room where I would be making videos and doing my praying and all that, it's going to have these Florida Lee on it. And then the floor of the house that I lived in for 5 years here in the Philippines, where it flooded and all that, it had that Florida Lee on the floor. You know, it's like some kind of a stain or a mysterious pattern that appeared that I took a picture of. I posted it on Facebook, and I think I mentioned it in a video. I don't know if I showed the picture on a video. It's on my Facebook page. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord just reminded me, hey, this is a sign. You know, and I, like I say, I'm not into this confirmation stuff so much. I don't look for those things. I try to get the inward witness of the Lord instead of outward witnesses, you know. But the Lord does do outward signs and wonders, like the 4 blood moons and all those things, you know. And then He gives people personal confirmation through outward signs all the time. And He has done it to me many times. So this is one of those, brothers and sisters. So I was just like, hey, you know. And then when I was there tonight, I realized, hey, I'm wearing my Rapture shirt too. Hey! Anyway, praise God, brothers and sisters. I want to give some the words. I try to go through the list. I guess I've got 50 names. I'm going to go through as many as I can right now. And there's some people who ask for a private word, and I will give them a private word as best I can. Anyway, brothers and sisters, here we go. Mary D. First one on my list is Mary D. And the word I got for you is strike the shepherd and the sheep shall scatter. Now, you know, I could go through each one of these. Maybe it means like in your church, the pastor would leave and then the church would break up. I mean, that's what I thought about. Now, that text is about the Lord Jesus. And, you know, he was saying, he quoted from Zechariah saying that, you know, when he would be stricken, when they would strike him, his disciples would run away, which they did. And that's the original application of the text. Now, what it may mean to you, I don't know, other than what I just said. So pray about it. Okay, Jesse Y. Sister Jesse Y. from Asia. I'll just say she's from Asia, not the Philippines. And this is the word I got for you. You know, the Lord gave me lots of cool words. It's like last time. The words from the Lord are getting more cool all the time. It's a sign of, you know, in the shift in what the Lord's doing through in my anointing and in my ministry. So praise the Lord for that. Here's the word. Jesse Y. Frame your time in prayer. Say a prayer in the morning, say a prayer in the noontime, and say a prayer in the evening. Say a prayer in time. In the time frame. Say a prayer in the time frame. Now, I just want to tell you this. It's not saying that everybody has to pray three times a day. The word from the Lord for you is say a word of wisdom. Say a prayer in the right time frame. In the right time frame. Say a prayer in the... Frame your time in prayer. Say a prayer in the morning. Say a prayer at noontime. Say a prayer in the evening. Say a prayer in the time frame. Rachel Love. Her real last name is not Love. That's why I said it. Count. Count the cost. Sign of the times you saw. Yes, the sign you saw was from my hand. Know that I am even at the door. Knocking on his heart. Count the cost. Sign of the times you saw. Yes, the sign you saw was from my hand. Know that I am even at the door knocking on his heart. That's the word of the Lord for you, Rachel Love. Now, when I wrote that twice like that, you know, it's just like if I was speaking, the first thing I heard from the Lord was the word cost. And then the rest came. And that's how I wrote it just exactly as I heard it from the Lord. And sometimes it's very important, exact saying, and then sometimes it's not. It depends on the situation. God is like that. Lots of times he says something, it's like the exact words that what we prayed. I have many people that message me. Brother Gary Bear 049 is a great example. He had prayed exact words, and the Lord gave me the exact answer many times, and vice versa. So we know that we're hearing from the Lord by confirmation. And of course, what we say is matching the word of God. Rachel Love, I'll say it again, cost, count the cost, sign of the times you saw, yes, the sign you saw was from my hand, know that I am even at the door knocking at his heart. Deidre H, time is of the essence, run, 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 now, 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 peace, peace, peace in your natural flesh. Peace in your natural flesh, time is of the essence, run, 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 now, 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 peace, peace, peace in the flesh. Amber H, forsake not the things of the Lord. Redeem the time given unto thee. Repent, turn back now. You know, almost always I give a word of exhortation, you know, and it's all cool. Sometimes the Lord gives a word that's not exhortation. Amber H, forsake not the things of the Lord. Redeem the time given thee. Repent, turn back now. Cameron S, sight unseen. That's all I got for you. I got the same word for somebody about a month ago. The word I got, or 2 or 3 months ago. Cameron S. The word I got for you is sight unseen. Oh, never. I've got something else too. I'm sorry. It's the second line. This is amazing. The first thing the Lord spoke to me when I started working on this list was to skip down through those names to your name. Cameron S. And the Lord gave me an expression in Spanish. Dios, 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 or Dios, Dios, ¿cómo va si Jesús? Now, Dios, Dios is, you know, the Lord or God. And then, ¿cómo va si? I had to go look it up because I didn't know what it meant. I know the, you know, Dios, because they use that in the Philippines. ¿Cómo va? I didn't know what it meant. As well as, I think that's the meaning of it. Dios, Dios, ¿cómo va si Jesús? Which I think it means, you know, Lord, Lord, even is Jesus, I guess. Or you know, or even Jesus. It's expression, sight, and I got sight unseen when I went back through it. As I started going down the list, what I've gone through so far, I got sight unseen. But when I first opened the list and started working on it, the Lord led me to jump down to your name, Cameron S., and I wrote in Spanish. Dios, Dios, ¿cómo va si Jesús? And like I said, I had to look up what it means. And I think it means, you know, Lord, Lord, even Jesus. I don't know. Just all these things I wrote is what the Lord put in my spirit. And that's, you know, unless the Lord tells me, I can only speculate on the meaning. Tom C. Scattered, scattered is the seed. Gather, gather in the sheaves. See, the Lord has been giving me all these play on words and poetic meanings that is new for me. Tom C. Scattered, scattered is the seed. Gather, gather in the sheaves. Now, scattering can be sowing seed, too. You know, you scatter, some seed is sowed and some is planted. When you plant seeds, you know, you put one every 2 or 3 inches or whatever. And then you can sow seed. It's just to throw a handful. You know, my grandpa was a farmer, and we used to do a garden every summer, too. So to sow is to, you know, throw it in there liberally. To plant is just a little bit here and there. Most people, if they even give, you know, they just plant a little. They don't sow it. Sow it as you put a whole bunch out there, right? Let's see. So scatters the seed could be throwing it all over the place, or it could be, you know, sowing it versus planting it. Mary Ann C. Born of the Spirit, born of the earth. Great is thy faithfulness to me, says the Lord. Mary Ann C. Born of the Spirit, born of the earth. Great is thy faithfulness to me. That's what the Lord says to you. Penny B. Penny B. Light of the world and light of the path. His word has sent you. His word was sent to you in abundance. Penny B, light of the world and light of the path. His word was sent to you in abundance. His word was sent to you in abundance. Miles C, sanctify and grow in me. Sanctify and grow in me. Sanctify is two different sides. There's negative sanctification, which means take yourself away from the world, away from sin. Positive sanctification is get closer to the Lord. Read the Bible more, pray more. So it's two different sides of sanctification. So the Lord is telling you to sanctify and grow in Him. Jerry A. Jerry A. Let it be and know that I am the Lord. Jerry A. Let it be and know that I am the Lord. DeMontel H. DeMontel H. Clap your hands for joy and shout unto God with the voice of triumph, for I have given you the kingdom. DeMontel H. Clap your hands for joy and shout unto God with the voice of triumph, for I have given you the kingdom. That's pretty good. Abigail K. Let your yes mean yes and your no mean no. Abigail K. Let your yes mean yes and your no mean no. Darcy K. Darcy K. Delivery of the new birth comes by much travail. Delivery of the new birth comes by much travail. Now that's a play on words, and it's pretty genius. Of course, it's from the Lord. I would never think of to say it that way. Delivery of the new birth comes by much travail. Well, travail means labor. You have to be in labor. And delivery of the new birth, for me, it's saying that for someone to get saved, it takes a lot of birth pains. You know, so you got to do a lot of praying and seeking God for somebody to get saved who you might be praying for, like your family members, like your husband or whoever. You know, you're praying for someone to get saved, and it takes much travail. That's my understanding of what it means. my interpretation of the expression. Aisha M. 'Tis the season to be jolly, for I have set you for victory over all folly. How about that one? That's also a rhyme. You know, there's a sister in Canada, in Vancouver, Canada, that sends me, I believe it's Vancouver. She sends me this lovely poetry on this beautiful, you know, she even makes, you know, she even paints the paper that she makes it on and does, you know, designs on there. So beautiful. And praise the Lord, when she's going to publish a book, by the grace of God, she's going to, you know, I'm going to announce it on here and give a link where people can get her book. And I thought about maybe it's because she keeps sending me poetry, you know. It's, it's, you know, that spirit of the poetry is coming on me now. I'm going to do, I'm going to be doing poetry by the Spirit of God. So for Aisha M., 'tis the season to be jolly, for I have set you for victory over all folly. You know, all over all foolishness. God's giving you the victory over all foolishness, Aisha. So be jolly, be rejoiced, be happy, be full of joy, because God has given the victory into your hand. Okay, Manuel C. Signed and sealed and placed in a safe place is the heart of my people. I set my seal on you. I sign it in my own blood. Free at last, free at last. See the sign. Now, when I write these down, I can look over them and see. You know, when I write these down, I can look over them and see much better when I speak it. He does a play on the word sign. You know, at the end, free at last, see the sign. Like a sign is like the blood moon or something God would show you, like the Florida Lee I talked about in the beginning. It's a sign from the Lord. But when you sign something with your hand, the Lord is playing on that word. Signed and sealed and placed in a safe place is the heart of my people. I set my seal on you. I sign it in my own blood. Free at last, free at last. See the sign. Manuel C. You know, brothers and sisters, I just want to say this. We talk about the rapture and all that. Those who are truly saved, truly born again, truly walking with Christ, we're going to heaven. You know, that's the debate. There's two possibilities. You talk about people that are, you know, there's people debate whether, you know, once saved, always saved, or can you lose your salvation? And the real story to look at that is someone who's truly born again is truly born again, and they're walking with the Lord. There's another possibility that a lot of people don't talk about is false converts. There are tons of people who are false converts, you know, but the point is not to debate those doctrines, but to say, if you're a Christian, you're going to be walking with the Lord. If you're a Christian, you're not going to be doing A, B, C, D, and all that. You're not with the Lord. You're in the flesh. You're out there in the world, and you're living in sin. You're living in sin versus sinning and living in sin. I don't know why. I don't want to get into that. There's a difference between sinning. We all sin, but living in sin is a totally different thing. Willfully continuing in a known sin, repeatedly and repeatedly, unrepentant. I guess the majority of my videos are on that topic. Let's go on here. Sister UN, I'll say last name. She's from Asia also. Sister UN. UNZ, I'll go that far. Sister UNZ from Asia. The word for you is light. Are the burdens of the Lord. Let not your heart be heavy. My yoke is easy. Fear not. Sister Uns. I'll just say that. There's some more letters there from Asia. Light are the burdens of the Lord. It's probably your first name, not your last name anyway. It's your first name. Unzong. UNZONG. Sister Unzong. It's first name anyway. Light are the burdens of the Lord. Let not your heart be heavy. My yoke is easy. Fear not. Sister Unzong. Bill C. Cast your cares on me. Walk in peace, says the Lord. That's almost the same thing as Sister Unzong. Bill C. Cast your cares on me. Walk in peace, says the Lord. I double checked that two or three times because it was similar to the word I just gave to the Sister Unzong before you. Peggy W. Saved, sealed, and sanctified with the Holy Ghost. Peggy W. Saved, sealed, and sanctified with the Holy Ghost. Paulette J. Paulette J., our weapons are not carnal. It means they're not of the earth. I put that in parentheses. Our weapons are not carnal, but mighty in Christ to the pulling down of strongholds. Use the weapons I gave you, for you are at bat for the home team. Our weapons are not of this earth, but mighty in Christ to the pulling down of strongholds. Use the weapons I gave you, for you are at bat for the home team. Paulette J. Nancy S. Seek and ye shall find. Nancy S. Seek and ye shall find. Melissa S. Moisha is the lawgiver. I am the gatekeeper. No one comes to the Father but by me, Jesus Christ, says the Lord. Melissa S. Moisha is Moses. The Lord spoke to me in Hebrew. I don't know what to tell you. He gave me some words in Spanish and Hebrew. I don't know. Moisha is the Hebrew name for Moses. Moses is the lawgiver. I am the gatekeeper. No one comes to the Father but by me, Jesus Christ, says the Lord. I think that one's pretty self-explanatory, especially when the Lord used Moisha there. You know, we're not saved by the law. We're not made righteous by the law and by saying the speaking Hebrew, but by Jesus Christ. Rosemary from Florida. I put from F. I abbreviated the word. I assume it's Florida. Is there any other states that starts with F? I don't think so. Rosemary from Florida, I guess. Nostalgia for the things of God is religion. For I am the Lord God who saves thee. I am. Rosemary from Florida. Nostalgia for the things of God is religion. For I am the Lord God who saves thee. I am. I would say that it's the past things of God, to clarify that. Nostalgia for the past things that God has done in this, not in the Bible, but in the modern age. Let me clarify that. Because those ideas were in my mind, but I didn't write it down. Nostalgia for the things that God has done yesterday is religion. For I am, the emphasis on I am. Not I was or will be, but I am. The Lord God who saves thee, I am. Rosemary from Florida. Julia C. Lace in tatters, the veil is rent, for the glory of the Lord rises and shines in the darkness. Delight thyself in the Lord. Sail away, carried on the wind of my love. Julia C. Lace in tatters, the veil is rent, for the glory of the Lord rises and shines in the darkness. Delight thyself in the Lord. Sail away, carried on the wind of my love. Shauna D. It is your birthright. Receive it now in Jesus' name. Shauna D. It is your birthright. Receive it now in Jesus' name. All right, brothers and sisters. That's how far I got so far. I've still got a lot of names. And, you know, I'm going to keep working on it. You know, I'll make another one and hopefully I can catch up. God bless you guys. May the peace of the Lord be upon you. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, hallelujah. We praise you, Father, right now in the name of Jesus. I speak your words, Lord God, as you would lead me and allow me, Lord. I ask all those to come in agreement with me, hallelujah, that the word of the Lord be spoken, that the word of the Lord be received. These Rhema words of wisdom and of knowledge go forth and accomplish your will, Lord, as you said. Your word will accomplish what you please, hallelujah, Lord. Let your will be done through every one of these words, Lord God. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done in each of us as it is in heaven, Lord God. Hallelujah. Lord, set those things of the enemy at naught and cause them to be no more in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah. Let your will be done, not the will of the enemy, our own will, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord Father, in the name of Jesus. Let your kingdom come forth. Let your light shine in the darkness. Hallelujah, Lord, for the darkness receive it not, Lord, but your people, Lord, receive your wisdom, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord, let us and our light shine before men that they may see our good works, that we might glorify you, Father, who is in heaven. We thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for your Holy Word. We thank you for your love and kindness toward us, Lord God. Father, you are worthy. You are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, our righteousness. Lord, you are our righteousness, our steadfastness. Hallelujah. Our deliverer, our sanctifier, our savior. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Lord God. Hallelujah. And blessed be his holy son, Yeshua HaMashiach. Praise his name. Delight thyself in the Lord. Hallelujah. Delight thyself in the Lord. Hallelujah. For he is with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. For he has given us good gifts from above. Praise his holy name. God bless you guys. God bless you. I speak right now that the Holy Spirit would be come upon you and overtake you. Hallelujah. That you would be delivered and be delivered from all the travails in your life. Hallelujah. Not by might nor by power, but by his Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise God for the Holy Ghost. We thank you, Lord, for the Comforter that is with us and in us and to us and through us, Lord God. You've made all things new in Christ Jesus. Bless your holy name, Father. We honor you and we praise you in the name of Jesus. God bless, guys. I shall return, even as MacArthur returned to the Philippines. I shall return to the States by the grace of God, unless, of course, the Lord comes for his church before that, which I hope he does. If not, I shall return with a new video as the Lord wills.